What's going on, guys? Hope you guys are all doing well today. Thanks for viewing this channel. In today's video, what we're going to be doing is I'm going to be reacting to a few photos that I took off my Nikon D3100. If you guys have seen the last video I made of the Nikon D3100, I was just giving a quick user review and my thoughts, as it was my first camera, and it is a camera that I do cherish. I did like that camera a lot, so I thought, why not react to a few photos that I took and get your thoughts as well. Okay, so I'm looking at the first photo. So this first photo, I remember taking this. This was, I think it was close to springtime. And I was really, really curious. I was taking a lot of photos and I was, you know, so intrigued into the photography space. I was uploading on Instagram about 3 to 5 times a day and I was super, super consistent and it was a good experience. And I think what I did with this one is I was experimenting with colors at this time and I was trying to find a different kind of style with my photos and it didn't really work out for me. But yeah, for some reason I left this on my website. I don't think this is my best photo, but I do like the clouds. I like the fact that, you know, it looks a little bit different. It looks a little bit like a futuristic type of photo. I was trying to find a style that could be a little bit futuristic. So that was what I was doing in this photo. Not my favorite photo, but nevertheless, I think it's a decent photo. So the next photo. So this photo was taken, I remember this day. So if you guys are not following a guy called e.madou on Instagram, do follow him. He's one of the most amazing, humble dudes you'll ever meet. You know, he's a visual artist and the way he comes up with his images is just super creative. And, you know, he's grown and he's growing really, really fast. And I'm so happy to see his progression. And, you know, he's doing all these collaborations. Check him out. He's an amazing, amazing dude. This day I met up with him and we walked around for a bit. And this was close by Lionsgate Bridge. I remember this photo. He let me use his lens. I think it was it was a wide lens. So he let me use his lens and I was just taking photos and he was trying to capture, I think, some like reflections or something like that. And I remember this really, really well. This was a really good time and I like this photo because it kind of has a dynamic of everything. It has nature, it has, you know, the bridge, it has a little bit of the city. You can see some houses, and then it has the mountains and the clouds. I love clouds. Clouds is something that I really, really love to shoot when I was doing photography. And this photo is definitely, for me, is an iconic photo for myself. It's a photo that I really, really, when I look back at this photo, I tell myself, wow, like, you've come a long way. And yeah, we can see what I can do with this photo. That made no sense. So the next photo, this photo, a lot of people ask me if I shot this photo with a drone. This is probably my all-time favorite photo. I haven't looked at the other photos, so if I say it numerous times, then that could be the case, but this is my all-time favorite photo. I love this photo so much. Again, I was with Maddo that day, and it was super like it just shows pretty much everything, in my opinion. It shows the nature, it shows the city, shows the clouds, as I like it, shows the water, it shows Vancouver as a whole. And this photo was probably one of my most liked photos on Instagram. This was a photo that I was like, this photo is going viral. This is a photo that I would sell. This is a photo that I would get as a print. This is a photo that I would take to a trade show, and this would be my only photo. I love this photo so much, and you know, it's a photo that I really, really enjoyed taking, and thanks to Maddo for letting me use his lenses. It's one of the photos that, you know, I highly, highly cherish. And, you know, if I had a skill level that I had now and I took this photo, maybe it would have been different. And maybe I will do that. Maybe I will document that. But truly, this photo means a lot to me. This was a photo that I really, really enjoyed. I even collaborated on a project with a graphic design student. Basically, in school, we had to work with a graphic design student and we had to figure out how we can advertise what they're doing with our photos. So she used the photos and it came out really, really well, and I was super proud to see that. And it's something that I see myself using in the future, in the near future, maybe selling the work or maybe utilizing it in some other kind of way. So far, so good. I saw one photo I didn't like, but I think that you have to have photos that you don't like as an artist. You're gonna be critical of yourself, and that's just how it is. So the next photo, this photo here. So this photo was, I looked up a lot to an Instagrammer called Stays Inspired, and I really loved his work when I first started photography. I wanted my work to be exactly like his. The one thing about being a photographer or a videographer or just doing anything in that space is the fact that there's always gonna be people that you admire, and there's always gonna be people that you look up to. You're gonna look up to their work, and then you're gonna try to emulate their work, but you're also gonna add your own twist to your own work. So what I try to do here was, I noticed that Stays Inspired, he likes to use a wide lens, and I didn't use a wide lens for this one though, but he likes to go down low a little bit, and he likes to get the dynamic, and he likes to get the people around, and he likes to add colors to it. At this time, I was shooting a lot with blue. Blue was like my main thing, and I think blue is very symbolic for me because I grew up in Vancouver, and blue has always been something that I've been around. And even though my shirt is green, but blue is something that is very symbolic for me, and it does symbolize water. But I remember when I took this photo, one thing I would have wished I would have done was I wish I would have taken some more time on editing the photo. This is like when I first, like when I was starting photography, is probably back in like February of last year. So I was like a couple months in, and I was so excited to upload this photo that I didn't take the time to edit it. And then when I try to find the photo, the raw file, I couldn't end up finding the raw file because I don't know where I put it. It's a lesson learned, but I know that with my skill set that I can retake the photo anytime I want, and I'm excited to see what happens in the near future. So this is definitely one of the photos that's like very, it's also very iconic for me, and it's a photo that I try to emulate someone that I really liked, and because of that I had my own style as well, so I added blue. This photo is also iconic as well because it has Hudson's Bay. It also has the bus as well, and it's a very Vancouver type of photo. It doesn't normally snow here in Vancouver, so that's also a symbol as well. The fact that it doesn't snow here, then it really helps opens up a different kind of dynamic within the city. The city is very different when it snows. I prefer the rain or I prefer the sun, but snow is snow, and it's a different city, and when you're taking photos, snow is awesome to take photos with. And I had a photo shoot that day as well. I still remember that day. So the next photo, this was probably the shift in my photos. So what happened was I took a little break in photography, and I stopped taking photos for a couple of weeks. And I was still in school, and I was focusing on myself. Ramadan was here, so I was doing things to focus on my Ramadan. And it was something that I really had to work on. So this was my first photo back. Like, this was my first photo back, and this was a photo that really stunned a lot of people. It was a photo like, I'm backed here, I'm ready to go. This is the photo that opened the next chapter, I guess, of my own life. And this photo was taken, I was with a friend and we were just hanging out, and then I saw this and I was like, wow, this is so amazing. I can capture this. This is also something that I value very much because it's, like I said, it's my first photo back in action, and it's my first photo just trying to figure out what I need to do. And the fact that this was shot with a Nikon D3100, it shows that like the sky's the limit. There's so much you can do with that camera. Even though I have a new camera, that doesn't mean that I'm gonna leave that other camera. I'm still gonna be using it if I need to use it. If I don't sell it, I'm gonna use it as a second camera. I'm still gonna keep it with me. The controls are very easy to use, and I highly recommend it. This one, I love the fact that the colors are there, and like just the blue. And then this is at this time I had a Surface Pro, so the Surface Pro is an amazing product as well. It just gets so many of the lights in, it's so amazing. And with the bird as well, it's just, this photo really touched up on a lot of different things. Wow, I remember this photo really well. So this photo was taken during the Vancouver Lookout. They had an event, and they had like a sunrise type of event. this was probably the day that everything started to change for me in terms of photography. So, like I mentioned, the other guy, e.madou, he told me to come to this. He invited me to this. It was a sunrise type of event, and I agreed to go. And I didn't know what to expect. I was still very new into this space, and I was so unfamiliar with how the community is in Vancouver. And going to that, I met so many different photographers. I met photographers that I've known from Instagram that had a high following, and guys who I like appreciated the work. I loved their work, and it was amazing. It was an amazing experience, and I'm so blessed to have been able to go there. This photo, once again, Mato gave me his lens, his 10 to 20 Sigma. This was my first experience with a new lens. At this time, I was only using the 35 millimeter. I was using the 35 mil for everything, and I didn't know anything else beyond that. Matt was like, "Hey, take the lens," and I was like, "Okay, well, I'll try it." And then, well, as soon as I tried it, it was like sort of like you're sort of in a spaceship. Like, it was really, really cool. The lens is awesome. And then he told me to shoot the photo like that, and I took this photo, and it was so. There's just so much to in it. It's the city, it's sunrise. You can see that. You can see the colors are blending in nicely. And this was probably one of my favorite photos at the time. And it's definitely something that was super iconic for me. A lot of my friends, my classmates really liked this photo. It was super different because, like I said, I only had a 35 millimeter lens. So all my photos look similar. But when I rolled this one out, it was different. People were like, "Whoa, like this is not your average Ibra type of photo. It's not what I would shoot." So this photo meant a lot to me. And it was honestly one of the, it was honestly a great experience. And I thank Maddo for inviting me to the event, and I thank everybody who helped me just learn all these different things. So this photo was pretty rushed. There was a rainbow, and then I was like, "Wow, I have to take advantage of this." And I took it because at that time I was doing like Instagram, Instagram was like my thing at that time, and I would be uploading super frequently. So I uploaded this right away, and then I got a follow from CTV Vancouver, and it was awesome. Like, they shared it right away, and I got featured. And at that time, I was getting a lot of features anyways, but that was a big feature for me because I grew up knowing who CTV are and all that kind of stuff. So it was a very different experience, and I really valued that as well. I keep saying I value, but it was such a blessing. Like, last year was a blessing. The first 5 months, it was an amazing experience, and I really appreciate everyone who helped me along the way. And yeah, this photo, but then again, I feel like I could have done better with this photo. I feel like I could have taken my time. I feel like I could have, at least like lined up the camera a little bit better, maybe got a tripod and just takes a shot, maybe long exposure. It would have been so much better, but this was more at the time. It was a trend. I'm trying to get it rolled out, and people appreciated it anyways because it got rolled out at that time. And I mean, the fact that it's not photoshopped is something that's also iconic. I don't like to photoshop my photos. I might try photoshopping, but I'm not much of a Photoshop guy. So I like to keep it as authentic as possible. So this is how my photo came out, and it was an amazing experience. And yeah, so the next photo, this is a photo that I like. It's something it's quite simple. It's something that it's not too, it's not too over the top, but it's also sunset. You can see a little bit of the rays on the right. You can see like a little bit of that, the lens flare on the left side looks like a little bit of a rainbow. And you see the person paddling in the front, and you see the boats in the back, and you see the mountains, and you see a lot in the photo. You have to look within the photo. This is a photo that it's not something that you can look at for in a second and it'll just be like that. It's a photo you have to like really analyze. And it's a shame with Instagram, you look at a photo and you're like, and then you go straight down. This is a photo that you would have to look into and you have to really analyze. I really do like this photo personally. I think this photo is a photo that can really resonate with a lot of us. And it's something that, sometimes if we're having a down day, we can look at a view like this. And this is like sort of serenity and sort of, very zen-like type of feel. I took this photo when I was hanging out with a friend called Carl. I was doing some photos for him, and everything went okay. And yeah, it was an amazing experience. So the next photo is, oh yeah, so this photo, was taken. So I had an assignment for school. We had portfolio. So we had to assign, we had to have at least like 10 to 15 photos for our portfolio. So our best photos. This one was taken at Rocky Point in Port Moody. And basically what happened was my brother was standing there, and then I decided to grab my tripod, and at that time the clouds were moving. It was between golden hour and blue hour. So it was like, sunset had already gone down a little bit and it was starting to change. And all these colors are pretty authentic. This is not like something, it's all authentic. What I did here was I just put my tripod in, I did sort of a long exposure. So the clouds are moving, and then you can see the lights are, you could see the water is very smooth. And then you see my brother, he's there, he stood still and he didn't even notice, but I just decided to take the photo, and yeah, it came out really well. So the next photo, this photo is nice. I like it. I was hanging out with some friends and I took the photo, and a lot of people liked the photo. They're very impressed with the photo. It has that very like professional kind of look. The lights are awesome. This is where my photos started to change and they started to get a little bit better. And this is a time when I was looking at more valuing the time that I'd taken my photos instead of just rolling out photos like before. My next photo, this photo is it's the peony. I like this photo, a lot of nature. This is when I started using the kit lens for my Nikon D3100. A little bit of quality loss as you can see, but I think that the photo itself, it's a great photo. It's pretty stellar. It could be done better, that's for sure. But overall, I do think that the photo is, well taken, and it's decent. So this photo was taken, I was meeting with a few Instagrammers and we went out and we hung out and we did a collaboration type of shoot. And I took this photo, I didn't even realize how nice this photo would become. The colors are great, everything is just so precise. This is what about, like I said, this is like I said, how when my photo started to change, it started to get so much better and it was so much smoother. It was an amazing experience, and I didn't use a tripod, I just stood there and I just clicked away. And all these are shot with a Nikon D3100. Then the next photo was the same day, same concept. I just took the photo and then I edited it and then I made it smoother. And yeah, there's not much to be said about this photo, but this photo was a nice photo and I really enjoyed it. And yeah. So the next photo, this photo is a photo that I use on my website. If you guys go on my website, you can see this on my website. So this photo is on my website. I like this photo because this is a photo that I took and I was like, wow, this is the types of photos that I want to start taking. So I just grab a tripod and I use my kit lens. Yes, the kit lens. And what I did was I just put it there and then I got a good angle. I think it was like 15 to 20 seconds of exposure. And I just left it there and then it came out as this. And this is definitely one of my favorite photos. I wouldn't say it's my favorite photo, but it's definitely a photo that I do like a lot. The last photo that I want to check out is this photo here, is basically taken at Lonsdale Key, and basically it's like the whole Vancouver. Now, I didn't have the best lens at that time. I had a 35 or 18 to 55. So it's kind of limited and you can see that the quality is not the highest, but it kind of looks like a shadow of Vancouver, and you can see all the iconic parts. You can see the moon. You can see a lot of different things within the photo. You can also see the port and you can also see Canada Place. This is one of those photos, once again, that you'd have to look at and just really analyze and just appreciate it. It's a photo that I took and I was like, this is also for my project for school. And I put my tripod in, I just cracked the shot, and then there you go. I think I had like maybe a less than 3 second shutter. So yeah, it went okay. And yeah, I really enjoyed that photo. And yeah, looking back at all these photos were taken with a Nikon D3100. And if you are currently trying to figure out what camera you should get and you're starting off with photos, get this camera. I'm honestly like, I recommend it. You could probably get this camera for like I said, maybe $140 Canadian. And in American, that's probably like $100. And you can do so much with this camera. You'd be surprised at how much quality you can get with this camera as you start to increase your skills. Once you start to get better in your skills with photography, you're just gonna feel like you're gonna see the benefits simply because you're so used to it. Now I could sort of use any camera and I could just slowly, it'll take me some time, maybe like 10 minutes to get used to it. And once I get used to it, I can do a full photo shoot with that. And I could pretty much use almost any lens because I just used that 3100 and that was my main go. And I shot weddings, I shot portraits, I shot so many different things with it. And I can't stress how amazing this camera is. And I honestly really, really recommend you guys to get this camera if you are on a tight budget and you're new to photography. Even if you're a pro photographer and you're on a tight budget, maybe this will be your investment. But that's gonna be it for today's video. If you enjoyed this video, please hit the like button, please hit the subscribe button, and also let me know if you want me to react to my portraits, the portraits that I took. Today, I just wanted to react to the landscapes and the types of landscapes that I took with an Nikon D3100. And I just wanted to do this video to stress that gear is gear, and it's all about what you do with that gear that makes things amazing. So, thanks for watching, guys, and I will talk to you guys in a future video. Peace out, guys. Thank you.